It's stuck! What do we do now?
We say, hello! That sounds friendly enough.
What a place!
We've got a phone for help. Oh, good. Here's a phone book. What was that?
That was a tantalizing tintinnabulation.
No, don't!
Ah, foghorn. One of my favorites. Such a big, deep sound.
Maybe one of these books was making the sound I heard.
I don't need to know how this turns out. I'm out of here.
Yeah!
What kind of place is this?
I wonder who lives here.
Lived here, Keisha. Professor Cornelia C. Contralto, eccentric and collector of sounds. Born 1807. Disappeared 1892.
How do you know that, Miss Frizzle?
Because after she vanished, they turned her house, this house, into the Sound Museum.
This is the Sound Museum?
I knew it. We missed the rehearsal.
Where is everyone?
Gone for the night, Tim. Which means we have the whole place to ourselves.
Oh, boy!
Oh, boy.
Professor Contralto devoted her entire life to sound.
Huh? What happened to her?
No one knows.
Well, I'll bet you anything she's a ghost wandering around this house seeking the perfect sound. Seeking the perfect sound, just like me.
Well, Carlos, you'll have plenty of time to find it. We're spending the night.
The night here?
But our permission slips didn't say anything about haunted houses.
Besides, there's no place for us.
Ah!
To sleep!
Oh, why look. 8 student-sized beds. And a teacher-sized annex.
It's almost as if someone were
expecting us.
Be sure to get lots of rest, class. We have a concert tomorrow.
Now maybe it'll sound like a ghost.
Carlos, that's the ploopiest yet. It's too late anyway. He'll never find a sound now.
Cornelia, if you're out there, will you help me make this thing sound right?
Carlos, Miss Frizzle said if you kept asking questions, you'd keep getting answers. Was that an answer?
No, but that was...
Don't be silly, it's just...
Yeah!
Crazed ghost, bound forever in the chains of eternal torment, coming to get us!
Terrifying.
Very sly. They comes in ones and twozles, but if they so choozles, before your eyes you'll see them multiply.
Fly.
They're extraordinary, so better be wary, because they come in every shape and size. If money's what you covet, you'll find that they love it, because they does so love the thing you prize.
They're green, they're blue, they're pink,
they're white, they're large.
They tie themselves in horrible knots.
They come in stride as polka dots.
Beware, beware, be a bear, beware, beware.
Because they come in every shape and size.
Well, Carlos, you got us into this. Any ideas how to get us out?